I know that there are those out there who look at the first three seasons of Three's Company as the only ones worth watching. And I understand, I really do. First the Ropers leave for their own spin-off show, and then we had the whole Suzanne Summers contract negotiation messing things up. But you know what? I think there are just as many wonderful moments during the later seasons of the show, and a lot of that had to do with the new actors that were added in as the show progressed. And Jenilee Harrison, well, she was a big part of the ongoing success of that show. So let's talk a little bit about Jenilee. She joined Three's Company during season 5, playing Chrissy's cousin Cindy. Cindy was a cute but klutzy farm girl with enough similarities to Suzanne Summers' character that the writers didn't have to do much to the episodes that had been already written for the season. A few minor edits and voila, Chrissy's lines became Cindy's. Although Jenilee was a relative newcomer to TV audiences, she'd already been performing in front of huge crowds for a couple of years. You see, Jenilee was a Los Angeles Rams cheerleader. Yep, she was actually part of the very first squad of cheerleaders for the Rams, and that exposure led to her very first TV gig on Chips. And wouldn't you know it, on that TV show she played a cheerleader for the Los Angeles Rams. From there, Cindy started to find other opportunities, including a guest spot on a short-lived TV show starring Mark Harmon called 240 Robert. But it was the role of Cindy Snow that really thrust Jenilee into the limelight. I love this little snippet from a magazine article that seems to have been written by the ABC PR team themselves. As great as Jenilee was, I'm not sure that Three's Company viewers were really going to forget Chrissy Snow. That said, Jenilee was great. I really enjoyed the episodes that she appeared on during seasons 5 and 6. Truthfully, I never understood why the producers of the show decided to bring on Priscilla Barnes. I thought that the character of Cindy filled the void left by Summers' departure quite nicely. However, despite getting added to the opening title credits during season 6, that season turned out to be her last with the show, as the script centered more around Jack, Janet, and Terry. Moving on from Three's Company, Jenilee starred in Dallas, playing Jamie Ewing from 1984 to 1987. Her character had the honor of dying not once, but twice on that show, due to that crazy season that just turned out to be one of Bobby Ewing's dreams. And around this time, the mid-80s, it really seemed like Jenilee was everywhere. She was pitching Us Magazine and television ads, flexing her muscles for CBS on a couple of editions of Battle of the Network Stars. And heck, if you blinked, you missed it. But she even made a cameo in a Loverboy music video for their song Lovin' Every Minute of It. And she certainly made an impression on me in the James Garner movie Tank. I really loved that movie when it came out. Harrison was just part of a very talented cast in that movie, which also co-starred C. Thomas Howell and Mama Partridge herself, Shirley Jones. After making tons of guest appearances on television shows during the late 80s, the 90s didn't appear to be as fruitful for Jenilee. Sure, she made a handful of appearances in B-movies such as Illicit Behavior and Fists of Iron. But it would also seem that Jenilee started focusing on herself and her state of fitness, both body and mind. In 1993, she married Dr. Bruce Oppenheim, a prominent Los Angeles area chiropractor. Here he is pictured with one of his two children. And if the name sounds familiar, it's probably because the good doctor had been married before to another famous blonde. But let's get back to Jenilee. Her love of physical fitness allowed her to find opportunities on infomercials, and the one that I remember best was for the Abflex, a low-cost exercise device that promised amazing results if one would just consistently use it. I've got to say that I must not have been consistent enough because my abdominal region, well, it's more of a keg than a six-pack. More recently, Jenilee has really embraced her Three's Company roots by appearing at various conventions and other events where fans can visit and get autographs. And along with Richard Klein, Joyce DeWitt, and Priscilla Barnes, she also participated in the Three's Company 40th Anniversary TV show. That reunion show has been uploaded to YouTube by Antenna TV and can be found on their channel. If you're a fan of Three's Company, you need to watch this show. Now, if you are a super fan of Three's Company, It would appear that Antenna TV has also sponsored a cruise where Jenilee and her co-star Richard Klein were along for the ride. I'm not sure if there are any more slated for the future, but I'm sure there were many opportunities during that cruise to meet and greet Jenilee and Richard, along with other stars from 70s television shows. So you might want to keep your eyes peeled if that sort of thing is of interest to you. Jenilee has also stayed in touch with her LA Rams roots. Here she is pictured with many of her original cheer sisters from that 1978 squad. So you know what? From everything that I can tell, although she may not have the same level of fame that she experienced 40 years ago, Jenilee's life seems to be exactly where you would hope it would be. She seems happy and comfortable with who she is right now, and she is able to fondly recollect and celebrate those cherished moments from years gone by. And regardless of what we've all done in this life, I'd say that's what we all hope for, right? As we all get a bit older and maybe just a tiny bit wiser, I think we all want to be able to look back and feel good about what we've accomplished over the years, just like Jenilee. So that's it. One more picture. Here they are, Jenilee and Richard. Oh, so many years ago. Man, I loved that show. Anyway, please share your memories in the comments section. And while you're at it, I would love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And I'd be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my little channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.